Hi, everyone, and welcome to another Wellspring Early Years Center virtual circle time. Today's theme, Under the Sea. For this, you will need some paper, colored or white, crayons, markers, or pencil crayons, popsicle sticks, straws, or pipe cleaners, scissors, and glue or tape. Pause this video now to go get your equipment.
Hi, everybody. My name's Michelle. Do you guys remember circle time with my friends Paula and Stephanie? Well, they had to go back to school. They told me how much fun they had with you guys. And so me and my friend Amy, who's not here today, but she'll be here soon, decided we would do some circle times with you for the rest of the summer. How does that sound? Awesome. So one thing Paula and Stephanie taught me was the hello song that they like to do. It has some tricky sign language in it. Do you remember it? It's okay if you don't. We'll practice the sign language right now. So there's four signs that we have to learn. The first one is hello. Take your hand and you say hello. The next one is friend. Take two fingers, show me your two fingers. Very good. And then you make them hug one way and the other. That's friend. So do you remember the first one? Hello. That's right. Hello. Do you remember friend? That's right. Take two fingers and make them hug. Very good. The next sign is time. This one's pretty easy. You point at your wrist like you're wearing a watch. Time. And the last sign we have to learn is say. You point at your mouth. Where's your mouth? Very good. Right here. So the signs are hello, friend, time, and say. So I'll sing the song once for you, and then we can sing it all together, okay? Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. It's time to say hello. Okay, are you ready to do it with me? One, two, three. Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. Hello, my friends. It's time to say hello. Very good. That was an awesome job. Do you guys know what season it is right now? That's right, it's summer, which means it's really hot.
One of my favorite things to do in the summer is to go swimming. You can swim in lots of places. You can go swimming in a pool, maybe one that's even in your backyard. You could go swimming in a lake, or you could go swimming in the ocean. And what else lives in the ocean? That's right. There's fish, there's whales, there's sharks, and even more.
Really neat place. I actually have a book that I really like about what it's like under the sea. It's about some friends that live underneath there called the Octonauts. Would you like to read that book together? Okay, let's read the book.
Our story today is called The Octonauts and the Frownfish. It's by Meow Me, edited by Don Men and Tracy Swedlow. It was a quiet and rainy afternoon at the bottom of the ocean when Professor Inkling was dusting his dust jackets, Quasi Kitten was watering his catnip, Tunip the Vegemal was tossing a salad, Peso Penguin was pinging, Shellington Sea Otter was ponging, Tweak Bunny was playing a game, Captain Barnacle Bear was singing in the rain, and Dashy Dog was sounding the Octo Alert. The crew hurried down to headquarters to find Dashy monitoring the octopod screens anxiously. "There's a fish with a very big frown outside," she reported to the others. "He looks so glum that all the creatures around him are starting to get upset too." I can't find a fish like him on the Octonet, Dr. Shellington said excitedly. Could he be a new species? Octonauts, we should investigate, Professor Inkling declared. Up close, the little fish looked even gloomier. Why are you so sad? Dashi asked with concern, but the fish only replied, glub, glub. What a dilemma. None of the Octonauts spoke the same language as the frown fish. Perhaps if we understood his language, then we could help him, Dr. Shellington proposed. Shellington and Dashi spent hours in the lab trying to learn his language, but it proved to be a very difficult one to translate. I don't think we can work much longer, Dashi sighed. I'm starting to feel unhappy myself. Let's think of other ways to cheer him up. Playing music with my friends always brightens my day, Peso shyly suggested. He invited everyone to pick up an instrument. As the crew gathered together to play a happy song, other creatures joined in. There is a clam capella group, a sea orchestra, and a baritone whale. Unfortunately, the frownfish didn't have an ear for music and continued to pout. It's hard to feel sad when you're being glamorous, Quasi announced with a flourish. Let's have a dress-up party. The little fish tried on many different costumes. Cowboy, ghost, princess, wizard, vampire, bumblebee, and more. But none of them could disguise his sadness. A game of miniature golf always tickles my fancy, revealed Dr. Shellington. The group putted and swung their way through many aquatic obstacles. Sand shark traps, sea dragons, and electric eel tunnels. The frownfish scored a hole-in-one on the king crab course, but he didn't look any happier. I like working with my paws. Let's go build something, Tweak suggested. Surrounded by gadgets and contraptions, the crew constructed a robo-tank for the frownfish. Tweak stood back and admired their work. Now, our friend can use his sea legs to visit us inside the octopod. But if possible, the frownfish looked even frownier. Tunip chirped eagerly as it led the group into the kitchen. Vegemals love to cook and bake. Maybe the frownfish is hungry, Dr. Shellington interpreted carefully. The whole crew set out to make their favorite pastries. They baked kelp cakes, kelp muffins, and even a fancy kelp souffle. The frownfish ate an entire plate of cookies, but he still looked unsatisfied. I always feel better after I exercise, Captain Barnacle said. The Octonaut swooshed down the slide, climbed the jungle gym, and rode the seesaw. Peso and the frownfish sat on the merry-go-round while Quasi pushed them faster and faster until, whoop, the frownfish flew right off. The little fish turned, bounced, and rolled over. Everyone rushed over in alarm. They'd only been trying to cheer him up, and now he might have gotten hurt. To the Octonaut's surprise, the frownfish had a big smile on his face. Of course, Professor Inkling realized, he's not a frownfish. He's an upside-down fish. There are different types of fish that swim upside down. It's easier for them to spot food. This chap is a fine example of an upside-down catfish. Everyone laughed in relief to discover that their new friend had been smiling the whole day. The catfish made a big erp and turned himself back upside down. Or was it right side up? The end.
Hey everyone, what did you think of that story? My favorite part was when all the Octonauts shared what makes them feel happy when they're feeling down. What's something that makes you feel a bit happier when you're feeling sad? Those are great ideas. Sometimes it helps to have a cuddle, sometimes take a big deep breath, play with your favorite toy, or maybe sing your favorite song. Something I like to do when I'm feeling down is dance. Do you guys like dancing? Well, I have a pretty fun idea for a dance, and it's called the seaweed dance, and it's under the sea theme, just like today's circle time. Would you like to do it with me? Okay. So first of all, we have to learn what seaweed is. Do you know what seaweed is? It's like grass that grows at the bottom of the ocean and it has big, long arms. So if we were going to dance like seaweed, we'd have to be stuck to the bottom of the ocean. But our arms could be like the big, long pieces of seaweed blowing and moving in the water. Do you think you can dance like this? Awesome. And then what if a big wave came and pushed a little crab out from underneath the seaweed? Crabs, they kind of look like little bugs on the bottom of the ocean floor. They're not very good at swimming, but they can walk along the sand, crawl along the sand. Do you think you can crawl along the sand like a crab? And what about being a fish in the water? The fish swim around the whole ocean. They can run around. If your whole room was the ocean, they'd run all around it. So can you dance like a fish running all over, showing your best fish dance moves? Very good. And what about a dolphin? Dolphins can do big jumps in the water and big spins even. And so if we were dancing like dolphins, could you do your biggest jumps and your biggest spins? Okay, so let's turn on some music and we can do the seaweed dance. I'll get the music and you make your favorite seaweed pose on the bottom of the ocean.
Ariel, listen to me. The human world, it's a mess.
Okay, everyone. Let's see your seaweed dancing stuck to the bottom of the ocean.
It's always greener in somebody else's lake. You dream about going up there.
Very good. Those big arms and legs.
Around you, right here on the ocean floor. Such wonderful things around you. What more is you looking for?
Okay. Now move around like the crab.
Under the sea. Darling, it's better down where it's wetter. Take it from me.
Moving all around the ocean floor. Good job.
Out in the sun, they slave away. While we're devoting full time to floating under the sea.
All right, now let's see your fish dancing. Can you move all around the ocean?
The fish on the land ain't happy.
Show me all your different swimming moves.
But fish in the boat is lucky. They in for a worse fate.
Good job.
One day when the boss get hungry, yes, you go beyond the pay.
Okay, now let's see your dolphin jumps.
Under the sea. Nobody beat us, fires, and
maybe even some spins.
We what the land folks loves to cook. Under the sea we have to hook up. We got no troubles. Life is the bubbles under the sea.
Very good.
Under the sea.
Awesome.
Amazing dancing, everyone. That was so good. I have one more under the sea activity for us today, and it's a craft. I was thinking we could make some fishy puppets. So we're going to need a little bit of equipment. And I have it all right here in a crafts box. First, we're going to need some popsicle sticks, or straws, or even pipe cleaners. Then, you're going to need some glue or some tape. Next, you're going to need some markers, crayons, or colored pencils. Next, some scissors. And lastly, some paper. And it can be colored or it can be white paper, whatever you have. So, now you can pause this video and go get that supplies. Okay, now we're back. The first thing we have to do is make a tracing of our hand, which is what we're going to turn into our fishy. So, to do that, take your piece of paper, you put your hand on it, and you can ask a grown-up, or you can try it yourself, to trace your hand on the paper. So you end up with something that looks like this. Then, use your scissors to cut it out. If you need help, make sure you ask a grown-up, because this part's tricky. When you're all done, you'll have a nice cutout of your hand that looks just like this. So, go ahead and pause this video and make your cutout. You can make as many as you want. Okay, now that you have your cutout of your hand, it's time to turn this hand into a fishy. So if we turn it sideways, what's it missing? Yeah, it's missing a face, it's missing its scales, it's missing its fin, and it's missing some gills, which is how a fish breathes. So why don't you pause the video and decorate your fish however you want. Come back whenever you're done. Okay, now that we have our smiling, colorful fishies, we can turn them into a puppet by taking our popsicle sticks, straws, or pipe cleaners and taping or gluing them to the back of the fish. So, pause this video now and get your grown-up or do it by yourself and make your fishy. All right, now you're done making your fish puppet. You can make as many of these as you want, flip them upside down and make a jellyfish, or right side up and make some seaweed and do a whole puppet show. Well, that's our last activity for today, but tune into our YouTube tomorrow for a parenting workshop on how to talk to your kids about tricky topics. And then next week we'll be posting our circle time on wacky weather. But to say goodbye, how about we sing the hello song, but add goodbye in? Does that sound good? Awesome. That also means we have to learn the sign language for goodbye, but it's pretty easy. You take your hand, you go like this, goodbye. So, I can sing the song once to remind you what it sounds like, and then we can sing it all together. Ready? One, two, three. Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, my friends. It's time to say goodbye. Let's sing it all together to finish off our circle time. Ready? One, two, three. Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, my friends. Goodbye, my friends. It's time to say goodbye. Okay, everyone, have a great week. I hope you had fun. Goodbye.
Thanks for joining another Wellspring Early Year Program Virtual Circle Time. See you next week.